I see what's happening, yeah. You're face to face with greatness and it's strange. You don't even know how you feel. It's adorable. Well, it's nice to see that humans never change. Open your eyes, let's begin. Yes, it's really me, it's Maui, breathe it in. I know it's a lot, the hair, the bod. When you're staring at a demigod, what can I say except you're welcome for the tides, the sun.
Now I'm gonna show you the slip stitch seaming. We'll fold the loop together. So we have the stitch on both sides. We insert the hook into the first stitch. And the first stitch of the back, this side. So we will work these two stitch together from front and back. Like pull up one loop and pull through the loop. That's the slip stitch part. And you can adjust to make it tighter. We'll do the second one. You can see the front stitch and the back stitch. Now we poke through both stitches. Pull up loop, make slip stitch. So this is the way how to work the slip stitch seaming. And you will get little ridges, the little bumps like this on the back of the top of the hook. And also for the handle, and this part of the handle is work the same way. After we seam two stitches on both sides, we'll keep working in rounds for this part. We still will do chain one, and this chain we make it really tight, like before we said. Work into the first stitch. And the rest stitches around in single crochet. Okay, after lots of practicing, I think I finally got this. And this one, I think it will be really steady. And one thing I changed is I used very small hook, 3.5 millimeter hook, and the yarn is pretty thick. The yarn is about worsted, heavy worsted weight yarn, and it's cotton. Cotton is heavier and less the squishy kind of, it's less than wool or other stuff. So I use cotton and really small hook, and it will be a little harder than a big hook, but the fabric afterwards, it's really tight. Another thing I did is when I stuffed this, I didn't use the cotton stuffing or, like I said before, the waste yarn or anything. I used some materials like the t-shirt you don't want, things like that, because it's also the same thing, it's less air in there, it's not squishy, it's really packed tight when you stuff them in there. So I did that. Finally, I think I don't even need to put any other support for this part of the hook, and it will stay and really still. I'm pretty excited about this version finally. I am at the last row. I've already finished the last row. Now I'm going to make the top fan here and seam all the stitches and the back little hook inside of here. Now I did the one chain and turn your work. facing back side. When you tail the work front a little bit, you can see the stitch we will seam together. There are a few stitches, the ridge on here. And we're gonna work in those stitches. First one, we work a slip stitch. Slip one. Next one, we work a single crochet right next to the first stitch. On top of this bump, we make another single crochet. Now we get to the valley here. This stitch, we make half double crochet. It's because it's a little lower than the bump, so the half double crochet will make it look even with the single crochet. And half double crochet, on top of this bump, we make a double crochet. And another double crochet in the same spot. Now we've done the first row. And chain one. Turn your work back. Work slip stitch in each stitch we just worked. This one, it might be a little loose. We can just tighten up a little bit, make it neat. Slip stitch all the way. Right now we get to this part, we have to seam both sides together. And before you start close up this both sides, like seaming them together, we seam them with the slip stitch. Only use the crochet hook. And you should stuff as much as you can and also make the shape you like and then close up. If you stuffed it too full, it might have a hard time to seam this. So what I did was, I won't stuff it too full and give a little room and seam this about to here, halfway, and then I will stuff the rest in there and seam the rest stitches. Keep working slip stitch to the end of the point. Then we'll come back, see how the inside reverse hook works. I just seamed every stitch together. When you work to the end of this sharp point, it might be a little bit tight to work into both stitch on the very end, at the very end of this point, but you can do it. Now we're facing the inside of this hook. We will work in between the rows. We can see there is a little hole here in between every row. We'll insert the hook right in there. So the first one is in under the first row. We do a slip stitch. The next one in the between the next row, you can tell it's really tight. You can try using an even smaller hook and poke in there to do this one. We do a single crochet half double crochet, double crochet, and the same spot, another double crochet. Okay, now we do the same thing. It's basically the same like you work the top, the fan. This is almost the same. Chain one, work slip stitch in each stitch to the very sharp point. Okay, make it tight, or else you will have end up with a little extra loop hanging there. So we'll make it that first chain really tight. All the way to very end. Okay. Now we can cut the yarn. Now I'm going to seam the two parts together. Once you get this pattern, it's actually not that hard to make this hook. It's only two parts, very less seaming involved. Now we're going to put the two parts together and seam them. We're going to, the only one thing little bit different than we seam some other amigurumi things, I'm going to stuff this not so full and leave about, let's say, half inch room to push the hook, the main part in there. You can even do this and to push a little bit in there to pull this out a little bit. Use the tool. Okay, when I seam it, I just seam under this reverse single crochet row, under here, and leave this part, the edge, without seam into the hook. And then after seam it together, and you weave all the loose ends into the body, and you're done. You will have a pretty steady Maui hook. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with this one. You're welcome.